I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme. Theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping on
Well, she was nominated for Best Newcomer at last year's New Zealand International Comedy Festival, and she's nominated for this year's Billy T Award. She's also a columnist as well as head writer. Head writer for Jono and Ben. And Funny Girls as well. Alice Sneddon is back with her show self-titled Volume 2, and she's here to tell us all about it. Welcome, Alice.
Yes. Oh, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Before we talk about that video, we must say, first of all, last time you were in the studio, you were playing a chef, and you played the prank on Mike, pretending to cut your finger off, and it was for Jono and Ben's show.
It was the ultimate prank.
I know, so many people talk to me about that. I went to a rugby game afterwards, I think 2 months down the track, and people kept yelling, oh, watch out for Jono and Ben, Mike.
Good. And I think that may have been one of my television debuts, actually.
Well, you play a foodie very
you
well.
Thank you so much. Chef remarkably well.
Oh, I appreciate that. I think that was my first and last acting gig.
Okay, hey, great clip to start
with.
Yeah, that was brilliant. How hard is it to make your show stand out from everybody else's?
Oh, it's impossible. They all just melt into one big blob, and I just hope that somebody goes, oh, I don't know what that is, but I'll check it out. That's the dream, right?
Well, that's always good, isn't it? Because you've got to do something, don't you?
Yeah, I don't care if my audience are into it or not, as long as they pay the money for the tickets.
And they're in there. Once you've got them on those seats.
Yeah, exactly. Once the cash is on my bank account.
So where does the funny come from? And do you have a funny family?
Yeah, I do have a funny family, I think. I talk a lot about my upbringing. I would describe them as funny and a lot of other things. But I know I talk about them a lot in my upbringing, in my show, especially about my parents. My parents are characters I've learnt. As an adult, it never occurred to me as a child, but now I know they're not normal.
What sort of things do they do?
Oh, they're just, they're like hippie accountants, which is just like the weirdest mix of
it's
people.
It's a weird mix, isn't it?
It's a really strange mix. So they were very liberal about some things and then like, you know, very conservative about others. So that's kind of what I explore, is like their active sex lives. And then, is that all right on the camera?
Yeah, no, that's all right.
It's after nine, kids are at school.
Oh, it's after nine. Yeah, that's when it gets really filthy.
So hang on a sec. How do mum and dad feel about this?
Well, they're in Europe at the moment, so
they don't know.
I don't know about that bit. But I've spoke about my mum at length and like how she gave birth to me naked in our living room and stuff, and she's comfortable with that, so I'd say she's on board with this.
Well, great material, I guess. But then when you look at your life, Alice, there's some great material in that, because you know, didn't you study to do something flash and then you dropped out of it and then you came back to comedy and then you know what happened there?
Oh, I went off the rails, eh? No, I studied to do law and I got admitted to the bar and everything, and then kind of like the day before I got admitted to the bar, I did my first stand-up gig and I was like, oh, I think I'll do that instead.
So you actually are a lawyer?
Yeah.
So we could, wow, that's great.
Well, that comes in handy if you're writing for Jono and Ben.
Yeah, exactly. I'm their in-house legal counsel. Yeah.
Do people use you a little bit as that? Like,
I've definitely written like mostly just letters to get out of parking tickets and that sort of stuff.
And have you ever been tempted to chuck in the comedy and go back to law?
No. Have you heard what law is like? No, I have no desire. Every now and I've never even thought about it. Right. My first ever job out of law was working in at Watercare, which runs the water reticulation across Auckland. And my job was proofreading the unitary plan. Wow. And I was so bad at it. I was listening to audiobooks as I did it, and I would find full sentences from the audiobooks in the unitary plan. I was like, I've got to quit this job.
So tell us about your show, self-titled Volume 2. How different is it from Volume 1?
It's a sequel. No, it's not. It's completely, you know, it's different in that it's all new content, but it's still all about me. So if you're not interested in hearing about that, I would steer clear.
No, well, I'm fascinated already. How hard is it to put something like this together? Because James was in it a couple of days ago.
Yeah.
And he, you know, it takes him about a year to get a show together.
Yeah, it's really tough just to generate enough like interesting content to do a whole hour where you're entertaining people, because I don't have any bells and whistles because I just wouldn't know what to do with them.
Right.
But so it's just me on stage with a mic.
Right.
So it does take a while, and I have a job and stuff as well. So, like, you know, that's a lot of work.
Yeah. Well worth coming along and seeing this one.
Oh, definitely. Come check it out.
Oh, sounds cool. Alice Sneddon is performing her latest show, self-titled Volume 2, until Saturday in Auckland as part of the Best Foods Comedy Festival. You can check out the Comedy Festival website for details. Thank you so much for coming, Alice.
Yeah. I'll come and see your show any day.
Okay. You mentioned Telly Ford, you're the chef
thing. That's right.